How long should you continue a drug that we call an atypical antipsychotic after the acute phase of illness? Well, in the case of post-mania, the studies would say that for the first 24 weeks, you have an advantage for reducing the chances of relapse than just using a mood stabilizer alone. And after 24 weeks, the lines tend to even out between mood stabilizer plus an atypical antipsychotic versus a mood stabilizer alone. Which means for the first 6 months, don't breathe on the regimen if the patient's stable. Get them through 6 months. And after that, you can certainly decide on a case-by-case basis whether there is or isn't an advantage for continuation treatment. We don't have an evidence base to suggest that. How about major depressive disorder as an augmentation? We don't have long-term data there, and we have to count in, well, tolerability issues. For example, metabolic dysregulation, extrapyramidal side effects, other than tardive dyskinesia, 2.6% annualized risk. This is a tough risk-benefit analysis, right? What if you've got someone who was in the VAST-D study who did really well with aripiprazole augmentation and they're euthymic? How long should they stay on the aripiprazole? Until they get a serious side effect? Until they get metabolic dysregulation? Until they show signs of TD? Until when? We don't know. We don't have an endpoint. This is why we have to clinically always do ongoing risk-benefit analyses.